Okay, I hope you enjoyed that quite a bit. I hope there's a lot of great discussion going on in the forums over your solutions. And we can go ahead and take a look at mine real quick, which feel free to break this apart. There are issues with it, and I invite you to find them. This is a very non-clever solution. First, it checks the type of the grid to make sure that it is a list and that the length of the list of lists is 9. Then for each row, we check the type of that, and then we check the length for that as well, and again for all of these. So this is basically just a type checking and length checking over and over and over again for each different part that we need to make sure about first off. Now, check each piece of the Sudoku puzzle separately. We don't try to check them all at once in any kind of clever way. If you did that, then congratulations. First, we check the rows from 0 to 9, and we instantiate a dictionary, and we check all the values. If the value isn't 0, and the value is already in D, in the dictionary, then we return false immediately because we've already found this in the row. So it shouldn't be there. We should only have this in there once. And then we put the value in D if we don't return and move on. And we do the same thing for the columns. Okay, for checking the subgrids, we basically just do additional for loops. We do the same dictionary checking as we did for the rows and the columns, but now we use I, J, II, and JJ as a shifter to check the row and column spot for each of these. 3 times I plus II shifts over to the appropriate subgrid. And similarly for the columns, with J and JJ. And after that, the code is essentially identical. We just check the dictionary to see if we already have the relevant value in that subgrid. And if we pass through all of this without returning false, then we return true. Okay, and when we run this solution, we see that we get the same output that we were supposed to get for the 5 test cases that were given. So go ahead and have a look at that. Like I said, there are issues with this code, and I invite you to check it out on the forums and discuss how you would break this, particularly how you would break this with a random fuzzer and what kind of problems a Sudoku checker might be vulnerable to with a good fuzzing test. So, okay, great. See you in the forums.